This is not going to be a Tajweed video, but it's an update on a previous video I've done, which was uploaded, I think, 22nd of June 2018, so about a year ago, entitled Lidl Croissant and Doughnut Are Not Halal or Vegetarian. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to HealMyTajweed, helping you read. So the quick update is that I've spoken to the Lidl branch of Tollgate Road, Beckton, East London. I think it was a few days ago or last week, I can't remember. But they have confirmed with me that their croissant are now vegetarian. I do not know about the donut, but I can tell you the croissant is vegetarian. I've spoken to the manager, I've spoken to the staff, and I've also seen the ingredient list in store itself. Okay, so this is just a quick update part, and you can stop watching the video if you want to, but in the next few bits I'm going to be addressing some of the comments I've had from that video, because some of it are a bit controversial. So the first main point is really addressing a very universal problem which happens on every single platform, no matter what anyone does on the internet or even in public on local platforms, whatever it is. There will always be people who will have something negative to say, regardless whether that thing is true or not. Now, I simply presented some information to you, and I said to you in the video that what you need to do is you need to go and check at your own local branch whether this is true or not and make a decision. I also told you in that video that this was not a fatwa, okay? Although it says in the title, but this is just for, you know, not clickbaity, but this is part of the process of making a title. I did mention that I am not giving a fatwa. I'm just simply sharing information that it is not vegetarian, and I have checked with, at the time, I spoke to the staff, I spoke to the manager, I checked their ingredients list, and I also contacted the Lidl headquarters. And what I got as an email from them was that they said to me, generally, their croissant should be vegetarian, but I should check with the in-store manager because it can vary from area to area, which I did. And I simply came and told you, you are supposed to now take information and not take it as absolute truth, no absolute falsehood, but you should go and check for yourself. That's what you're supposed to do, because I could be wrong as well. Now, you don't just watch a video, not just my video, any video of anyone, okay, who's presenting any information to you, and without making the sensible decision to go and verify that information, if you can, you should not be making a conclusion. This is what an educated person will do. But that just goes to show, if people are choosing to just make a decision, basically become a jury by just watching a video and also be the probably executioner and make a conclusive decision, you've cracked the case, then I'm sorry, you have no education whatsoever, okay? And I don't even want to address you individually. I'm just reminding generally anyone, and you know that we have a lot of problems on social media. WhatsApp is not a social media, but one example of forwarding false information, forwarding information which is not being checked on every single WhatsApp group I've been onto. It's always reminded, please check information before you send, okay? You have to check. And then if you can't verify, then you should not be making a conclusion. Whatever you want to believe, that's up to you. You can believe whatever you want to, but you can't make a conclusion objectively and act on it. So that's all I'm saying. Even today, when I'm telling you that the croissant from Lidl branch on Tollgate Road, Beckton, is vegetarian, you can't just take my word for it. You need to go and verify for yourself. Now, there is an update that at the bottom of each of their bread section, there is supposed to be a label. I checked it. There is a label. It is clearly indicated. I don't think we had a label before, but they have put it. I don't know when this update was made, but it is done. Now, the other thing I want to also tell you, that the manager I spoke to this time was not aware that the croissant was not vegetarian at some part. So probably it's a different manager or it's a different shift, but it can happen that not every staff will know everything in Lidl or any company, by the way. You know this very well. You speak to a person on the phone, they tell you something completely different to someone that you speak to later. It happens. So again, one of the staff, when I spoke to them recently, one of the staff had to correct the manager and said, no, we had vegetarian issue with the croissant not being vegetarian before, okay? Again, I'm only confirming the croissant this time, not the donut or other stuff. You can check. And that's the other thing as well. It is going to vary from area to area. Go and speak to the staff and find out for yourself. By the way, some of you who have indicated that or how dare I, there's no meat in croissant. I have explained before, a single ingredient can have more than one source. It can have a vegetarian source or non-vegetarian source. It can happen, and I'm not going to be giving you a list of different ingredients. You can go and check for yourself. And sometimes one ingredient can have more than one component, and one of the components could come from a different source. All it is that you just need to go and check. I'm not telling you what diet you should be on. I'm not telling you whether I'm not making fatwas. I'm not qualified to make a single fatwa on anything. I'm not saying halal or haram. I'm just saying to you, that was not vegetarian back then. It has been vegetarian since for a while. Maybe it will stay vegetarian, but you should go and check your local branch and try to find out for yourself. And I think that's kind of clear. Inshallah, I hope it's clear. There's far bigger problems in the world to be worried about. So, but I needed to just kind of update the video and put everyone at ease. So go and check, okay? Go and check. So in other news, inshallah, I am back into teaching. I will make a follow-up video into this. And we have very limited space. If you want to get in touch with myself, there will be my details at the end on the end screen card. So get in touch. And I'm only taking boys of 7 years plus, okay? Not before that. Again, we'll explain why later. So get in touch with me. I also can accommodate adults one-to-one online and locally as well. So if you want to come and learn with us, and I don't mean to say that I'm going to teach you, I mean to say that you and I are going to learn together, and if I can't help you, I will find you a better teacher than myself, inshallah. And just one last reminder, I have a second channel, which is actually my main channel, called HealMyTech. It's nothing to do with Islam, it's not on the same email logging, and I will leave the links below in the description. Please go and check it out. On there, I teach about tech stuff, repairing, and sometimes some entrepreneur stuff, nothing to do with Islam or Muslims. That's kind of an indirect da'wah. Alhamdulillah, it's working okay, but it could do much better with your help, inshallah. So go and check it out, give me some love. Please help the channel. There is a PayPal link through paypal.me/HealMyTajweed. And I want to keep doing the videos on Tajweed, and inshallah, now that I'm back into teaching, I will continue. There's a few backlog videos as well. Another way you could help me, my other YouTube account, which is HealMyTech, we have affiliate links to Amazon. If you click on them and you buy anything on Amazon UK and US, it will give the channel a small kickback, and everything will be put back into making the videos, inshallah. So please consider using them. JazakAllah Khairan. This was Ashik from HealMyTajweed, helping you read. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.